Now, when we want to break down anger, what does anger look like? It looks like addiction. It looks like thoughts of suicide. It looks like homelessness. It's like being reckless with your money and your life. That's which is kind of similar when we talk about the grieving process. This is part of it. So now we look at the misunderstanding, right? What does it look like? This is what your anger looks like. Now, you said something real interesting before, earlier, when you talked about how we was created to carry these, you know, these things. Well, we are equipped with these emotions. You know, it's funny how we're created. We was created very, very uniquely. We have these emotions, right? Our bodies are designed to move the emotions through. So when you get into, let's say, a really funny comedy act or something, right? Where do you feel your laughter come from? That comes from inside. It's a certain amount of vibration that sends these feel good and go, hey, that was funny. It's the same thing, right? When you experience trauma or loss, those same things come through your body. We have these cells in our body that vibrates. And the crazy part about it is that we're designed to move it through our body. Grief is something that can't sit in your body. It will make you sick. The longer it sits there, let's think about the ailments that come along with the anger and things like that that happens to the body. You have heart disease. You have kidney disease. Your blood pressure is up. You're always tired. You're always fatigued. All of these different factors that go into it. Well, where did that come from? It comes from your anger. It's trapped inside of your body. You have to move that through. But again, people don't get to that point because they look at it and go, I'm not going to express myself that way. Why not? Well, that's you being a girl. I'm not going to do that. But I go, what if you was wrong? And so what I've started doing, and there was something that I put together in one of my groups, I started putting together a music list. And it was something that I learned from reading about African traditions, right? And the grieving process. It's always fascinated me. It fascinates me more now because I want to understand more about it. You know, I want to build this relationship with it so I'm able to do better at what I do. And Africans or Westerners always say, you Easterners don't know how to grieve. What do you mean? He goes, you guys are grieving all wrong. What do you mean we're grieving all wrong? They'd be like, you don't grieve. I was like, well, you got us there. So it was like, okay, you got us there, man. We don't, right? You know, we take all of these things and you compile it and then you stretch it out. Now you can get rid of all the things that don't matter, get down to the source of what you're feeling. And then you can begin to allow yourself to move it through, but also allow yourself to go through these emotions. You can allow yourself, you can give yourself permission to go, you know what? I feel like crying right now. Why? Because I have this memory that, and I miss this person, or, you know, I have this memory of something that happened to me, and your body automatically knows what to do, right? So we throw some music in whenever you're going through something bad, right? And let the music move. You find yourself dancing around the house in the kitchen, no one knows why. Guess what? It's part of the process. You're going to have to let yourself do that. This is how we're created. We're created with rhythm. We're created with these cells that vibrate, right? And it's hitting the right frequency on each and every last one of them. And grief has its own set of frequencies, right? Our own frequency. So when you hit it, it moves. If it doesn't have anywhere to go, it just bounces around your body. It don't know what to do. You're not sweating. You're not screaming. You're not doing any of the things that your body is telling you to do. You have to give yourself permission, and then we can start tearing apart the anger. Why are you this way? Because it's going to open up your mind. It's going to free up space